Amen. Next time, madam, let us have the group to be singing here, walking, so that I know each and every group have known the song. So tomorrow we'll start with 0 to 6 years. They will sing during divine time here. Then the next day, follow like that till the last group. Today, we have a title, we are choosing God's way. Yesterday, we looked at how God chose us. God was the one who chose us. That's why we are in church today. Now today we look at our choices. We are choosing the God's way. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for being with us today. Bless us. Give us patience. Give us listening eye, listening ear. Let us be together throughout. Let every child get what you have prepared for. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to look at the story of the Israelites. But before we look at the story of the Israelites, the story of the Israelites are an example to us. But with us, we have choices. But sometimes we choose to listen to the radio. We choose to look at the television. We have different choices. Sometimes we choose food, what to eat. You tell your mom, today I don't like garlic. Today I want to eat beef. And peas instead of garlic. That is your choice. You choose the food you want to eat. You choose the dress. For example, some of us have been to the wardrobe choosing one dress after another. You don't know which dress to wear today. Is that true? Until we become late for church. You came late because of choosing where. That are different choices we make. But look at this Israelite. After Moses died, the man who was leading the Israelites was Joshua. So Joshua took the lead and he was leading the Israelites. But somehow, somewhere, the Israelites went astray. They worshipped idols, they danced the idols, they were doing evil things. They had forgotten God. Joshua looked at the group. They were disobeying God. Tell me one thing, but when you see someone doing, you tell that person is disobeying God. What can you tell me? What will that person be doing?
Maybe he brought a cow outside and bound to it.
Praying to idols.
Maybe he stands at and then out about God, and every day he goes to see that.
Bring the tree. Come here.
Maybe he made a golden calf and bowed down to it.
Making a golden calf?
Saying bad things.
Saying bad things to others. There's a girl there.
When I see
correct, means respecting their parents, not obeying the parents' rules, not listening to what your parents is talking. When you are not listening to adults, you are disobeying God. God is up there looking at us, watching what you are doing. Now, Joshua looked at everyone. Everyone was disobeying God. And he said words. Let's read the verse. Joshua chapter 24, verse 15. Very first, I want 24, verse 15. Are you there?
Joshua chapter 24, verse 15 says, "And if it seems evil to you to serve the Lord, choose for yourselves the day whom you will serve, whether the gods which your fathers served that were on the other side of the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you will dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord."
Joshua says, "As for me and my house, we are going to serve God. We are going to serve God." Joshua was telling people, that he is going to serve God. The people were disobeying God, but Joshua said, "Me and my family are going to obey God. We are going to choose to obey who? God." Look the way these people were coming all the way from Egypt. They crossed River Jordan. And we see here, they have seen God's miracle. But here they've decided to disobey who? God. But Joshua chose to obey God. He told people, "Okay, do what you want to do. Obey the Amorite God. But me and my family, we will obey our..." So Joshua decided to choose to obey God. How many of us would like to have a decision like Joshua? How many would like to choose to obey God more than other things? Good, thank you. Now let us sing this song. "I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No matter..." Okay, we know the song. Now let us sing louder. "I have decided..." "To follow Jesus, no turning back. If you have decided to follow Jesus, you don't look back. You always follow what Jesus wants you to do. Yesterday we saw that Jesus chose us to do his will. Now we should decide to do what Jesus wants us to do. Let us read Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy thirty. chapter 30, verse 15 to 18. It says, in that I command you today to love the Lord your God, to walk in his ways and to keep his commandments, his statutes and his judgments, that you may live and multiply, and the Lord your God will bless you in the land which you go to possess. But if your heart stands away so that you do not hear and are drawn away and worship other gods and serve them, I announce to you today that you shall surely perish. You shall not prolong your days in the land which you crossed over the Jordan to go in and possess.
Now, I want you to read that verse slowly as I talk. Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 15. Read verse 15 first.
Verse 15, see, I have set you today life and good, death and evil. In that I command you today to love the Lord your God, to walk in his ways and to keep his commandments.
Thank you. The Lord has given us choices. There is evil choices and good choices. But the Lord says we must look at the good choices. We must set our mind to follow what Jesus is saying, because he's there for us. Verse 16.
His statutes and his judgments, that you may live and multiply, and the Lord your God will bless you in the land which you go to possess.
So if we choose to love God with all our heart, we choose to do God's will with all our soul and with all our mind, then God has given us a land and he's going to bless every work of our hands through what we do.
But if your heart stands away so that you do not hear and are drawn away and worship other gods and serve them, I announce to you today that you shall surely perish. You shall not prolong your days in the land which you crossed over the Jordan to go in and possess.
But if we choose not to worship God, God has told us that we are going to perish. So we have to choose. We want to perish or live with God's blessings. If you choose to obey God, then God is going to bless you. But if you choose not to obey God, then you are going to perish. So, which way do you want to be? You want to be with God. Correct. So let us be with our God so that we get all God's blessings. We get all God's blessings. You can choose to love God, to pray for him. You pray everything. You be thankful to God. You also be glad for the place God has given you. You stop worshiping other things. For example, the Israelites stopped worshiping idols. They were worshiping idols. So they stopped worshiping them. So let's pray to God that he will help us make a good choice to our life. He will help us to choose to follow him and serve him. God, let us go. Now, let us sing again the song. Before I leave this place, let us sing again the song. I have decided to follow Jesus. Let's sing. To follow. Repeat the song again. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back. No turning back. So if you have decided to follow Jesus, from deep inside your heart, deep inside your heart, stand up. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for everything. Look down at on us. We are there at your feet, Father. We ask you to bless us, forgive us everything that has gone astray. Now we have decided, God, to follow your ways. Help us as children to be on your ways in all our daily activities, in everything we do at home, at school, and in church. Let everything we do become blessings to us, not what Satan wants us to do. Let everyone see your glory throughout our life. In Jesus Christ, we are praying.
Thank you. Can you sit down? So tomorrow, who wants to do the welcoming? Today. Do now. Okay. Scripture reading will be give. Then for the song, kindergarten will start tomorrow. Who have a kindergarten? Raise up your hand. You're not in kindergarten? The kindergarten are busy talking. Yes? So the kindergarten here, we'll sing the song tomorrow. Who wants to do the prayer? I want someone else. Elvis will do the prayer. Yes? Elvis will pray for us tomorrow. So, Yuna will be here. Listen, Yuna is going to be here. Yes? Keith is going to be here. Okay? Teacher Rose will be here. Elvis will be here. Yes? And then? Robert, oh no, the kindergarten will sing. Robert, you're going to sing with them? Okay? You will lead them. And then you will be the chorister to sing the first song, Praise God. Okay? Praise God from whom? Yes, you wanted to sing tomorrow. So that is the singing. Okay. So you have some 10 minutes till your parents come. You can run a little bit around. And then we can go home. Okay? But be careful, I've said. What did you just say? Yes. Thank you. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.